like to welcome you now to Danielle Obono from the Front de Gauche. Danielle.
Thank you, the Coalition of Resistance, for inviting me tonight and to give me the opportunity to bring this message of solidarity from France and from the Front de Gauche. So, you know, 5 years ago, when Nicolas Sarkozy came in power in France, it was something like the monster child of Margaret Thatcher and George Bush, full of promises. Those promises he made to big business and to the French ruling classes, and he said that he wanted to methodically deconstruct the program of the National Council of Resistance that would build after the Second World War, and that built all our social system, the health service, the social service, the democratic education, and so on. He promises that he would put an end to the tradition of resistance of the French working class, as symbolized by the spirit, what we call the spirit of May 1968. And at least we can say that he worked very, very hard to keep those promises. The pension system, the health services, education, even justice have undergone massive financial cuts and restructuration along the lines of the neoliberal new public management spirit. Not only that, but systematic racism, Islamophobia, and xenophobia coming from the top of the state, from the president to the ministers, have targeted and scapegoated Muslims, black people, immigrant workers, and that created an atmosphere in which the fascist and far right propaganda has gained legitimacy into the media, in the public opinion, and finally in the polls. So getting rid of Sarkozy on May 6th was a victory for the people in France, for the workers who have been on strike those past 5 years, for the pensioners, for the young Muslim, Arabic, and black people who revolted in the suburbs in 2005. It was a defeat not only for this racist and neoliberal government in France, but also a defeat for the authoritarian neoliberal axis in Europe, symbolized by Merkozy. We took part as a coalition, as an electoral and political coalition, the Front de Gauche took part in this victory of the people against austerity by doing mainly three things. I want to focus about three things. First of all, we built unity among the left, the political left, putting together people coming from all sorts of different backgrounds, from Communist Party backgrounds or Socialist Party backgrounds. Also trade unionists who got into the campaign, and people from no political background, citizens who just wanted to fight back. We also built a political program against cuts, against finance. We put a message contrary to François Hollande, who came to the city and said, I'm not dangerous. We said to the bankers that we will be dangerous to them. We will be dangerous against the bankster who created the price, and we will make them pay for that price. We also insisted on one argument and one element, very important, about people getting involved into politics, into social movements. One of our slogans was, take back the power, people's power. Because we knew and we know that changing rulers is not enough. We need to change the rules of the game. We need, in fact, to change the game as a whole. And if we needed any proof of that, the attitude of the newly elected French president, François Hollande, is a good example. François Hollande was elected to defeat austerity. We said no to austerity, and that we didn't want to choose between right-wing austerity or left-wing austerity. Because we made the campaign, because we gathered thousands of people into rallies, we organized march, and our arguments against austerity made him say that he would make a few progress for minimum wage and pension reinforced. But at the same time, he not only refused to meet Alexis Tsipras, the leader of Syriza, when he came to France, asking for support from the left candidates. He decided to meet, on the contrary, the leader of the PASOK, the leader of the party who was responsible for the mess Greece is in. And just last week, during the campaign in Greece, he blatantly advocated against a vote to Syriza, supporting the right coalition. And on election night last Sunday, which was election in France and in Greece, you have this apparent paradox to see the president and the prime minister from the Socialist Party cheering and celebrating the defeat of the right in France, and at the same time congratulating the right-wing party in Greece for its victory against Syriza. So this is just an example to remind us, and who reminded us, that we can count on anyone, and even if we got so-called left leaders in power, we can count on anyone but ourselves, our mobilizations, to achieve a real change. So just as the ongoing struggle of the people in Greece is giving us inspiration for the struggle we had to build in France, I think next October demonstration here will also be an important moment to build this chain of resistance across Europe that we need if we want to not only resist to austerity but also fight back and win another world. So just to finish, I want just to wish you all the best for the mobilization that you need to build here. And as we say in French, this is only a beginning.